It's time now for Look Latest in Local News. In the news, it's Election Day and polling places are currently open. Will remain open until 7 p.m. this evening as the city adjuster will decide three contested council seats and elect its new mayor, as both Ralph Hickox and Tyrone Johnson seeking that position. Not much interest in the early voting period, as only 1,004 votes have been cast in city adjuster elections. That's around 20%. Again, there are close to 5,000 registered voters, 4,000 have yet to vote. So hopefully a good turnout today, as the city's hoping to at least get over 50% of registered voters to vote in this mayor's race. Three contested council seats on the ballot. District 2's race between incumbent Don Dart and challenger Pamela Schumann. District 3, a newcomer to the board, as incumbent Nick Harris is not seeking re-election, so it'll be either former Commissioner Tim Cockfield or Stephanie Williams. And in District 6, the race is between incumbent Bill Harvey and Heather Altman. Once again, approximately 5,000 registered voters in the city of Jessup and 1,004 have voted early. In Scriven, there are 474 registered voters. Only 30 have voted early. Just 30, two contested seats on the council. On their ballot, seat 1, incumbent Brandon Harris and Adam Pruitt. Seat 5, incumbent Lonnie Murphy and challenger Tony Brinkley. Again, Mayor Jason Weaver and the rest of the council return for another term. Reminder, Scriven voters today vote at the new Sam Dreyer Community Center, again from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Here in Jessup, District 1 and 2 voters who used to vote at Bennett Union today voted Hall Richardson Recreation Center, so keep that in mind. Again, the votes counted tonight. Winners announced. We'll have the details for you tonight here on Big Dog Country FM 105.5. Talk with the winners. Have all that here tomorrow on the local news. The county meeting last night had to be canceled due to lack of a quorum. Again, only two commissioners showed up. City meets this evening. They've got a very lengthy agenda. We'll come back, take a look at that. And other news right after this word from our sponsor of the commercial messages, so please stay tuned. City of Jessup commissioners have a meeting tonight at 7 p.m. at City Hall. They've got a lengthy agenda. Under old business, second reading of a short-term rentals ordinance with City Attorney Michael Connor. Also second reading to amend the animal ordinance. Second reading to ordinance to rezone 231 and 241 South 3rd Street. First reading to request to rezone 242 South Brunswick Street from C1 to PR. Also discussion of COVID vaccine incentive with Commissioner Armstrong. Discussion of lead copper inventory costs with Water Department Supervisor Anthony Crawford. Under new business, discussion to request for a sidewalk on Macon Street. Discussion of transparency and integrity with former Commissioner Ricky Reddish. Warning a bid for manhole rehab. Warning a bid for a semi-truck. Warning a bid for a boom truck. Discussion of a $5,000 grant award for the wall mural contract. Approval of CDBG language access plan, resolution for City of Ethics recertification, two ordinances, revision of license fee, discussion of board appointments, executive session, discuss personnel and legal, items with the city manager, items with the commissioners, items with the mayor. All that tonight, 7 p.m. at City Hall. The Scarecrows Among Us contest winners were announced yesterday here on Big Dog Country at 105.5. The business winner, Piggly Wiggly. The group winner, City of Jessup. The school winner, Odom Elementary. And People's Choice was Hospice of South Georgia. Wayne County Yellow Jacket Band hosting the second annual Deep South Classic this Saturday, November 6th at JC Stadium. 11 bands from across the state will compete in several different categories, bringing several thousand students and visitors to the area. Yellow Jacket Band and the Valdosta State Blazing Brigade will perform at the end of the evening. Gates open Saturday at 11, with the first band performing around 12:40. Tickets are $10 for the entire day. They've got 13 different vendors on hand with the food and merchandise. Proceeds from the event benefit the Wayne County Yellow Jacket Band program. Once again, this is coming Saturday at JC Stadium. Once again, the gates open at 11. First band performs at 12:40. Again, the ticket price is $10 for the entire day. Reminder, the Chamber of Commerce has rescheduled their legacy dinner. It's set for next Tuesday, November 9th at the Pine Forest Country Club. Tickets available. If you need more information, contact the Chamber at 427-2028. We'll be back with some final news notes after this word from our sponsor of the commercial messages, so please stay tuned. Final notes and news. They're in week 3 in Glenn County attempting to select a jury to hear evidence in the shooting death of 25-year-old Ahmaud Arbery. They need 64 qualified jurors for the selection process, and they're expected to reach that number sometime this week. Once they strike a jury, opening arguments expected to get underway. Arbery shot and killed in Satilla Shores neighborhood. Video of the shooting has sparked a national interest in the case. Media from all around the country on hand for the event down in Glenn County. And they've got coverage as three defendants will stand trial. Greg and Travis McMichael and their neighbor, Roddy Bryan, who's the man who actually videotaped the shooting. Three men claim self-defense. Once again, it's in week 3 of the selection process for qualified jurors, but the report is they're very close to having that number. jury could be struck this week with the case getting underway sometime this week in Glynn County. Veterans Day Parade set for this Saturday, again, the lineup at 10 a.m. on Southwest Broad Street and West Cherry Street at 9 a.m. Banks Real Estate helping with the lineup and parade. If you'd like to entry into the parade this Saturday, please contact Banks Real Estate at 912-559-2142. But again, that parade this Saturday in downtown Jessup getting underway at 10 a.m. Wayne County High School has their annual Veterans Day Parade for the public. It's set for next Thursday, November 11th at 10 a.m. at the high school gymnasium. Once again, the public invited, especially all veterans, as the program is to recognize and honor them. Always a popular and very entertaining program. And that's set for next Thursday, November 11th at the high school gymnasium at 10 a.m. Reminder, the annual Wayne County Toy Drive has begun and will continue until December 3rd. Last year, the city provided toys to approximately 1,000 children in the community, giving them a Christmas of their own. The Wayne County Toy Drive Committee is dedicated to making this Christmas even better. It's a wonderful way to show your love and blessing this holiday season. Many local businesses can show their support by having a Christmas wrapped box as a drop-off for toys. Any businesses that would like to have that should contact Tracy Smith at City Hall at 427-1313. Toys can be dropped off through December 6th at City Hall. Monetary donations can also be made at City Hall. Checks should be made payable to the Wayne County Toy Drive. Again, they encourage everyone in the community to participate, help bring Christmas to those children in need. The Wayne County Toy Drive application can be obtained at Jessup City Hall. Deadline for all applications is Friday, December 3rd. Once again, if you need more information on the Toy Drive, call Tracy Smith at 427-1313. That's going to do it for the latest in local news. Sports comes your way in a few minutes. Bob Morgan, have a great day.